Pillars. What's up, y'all? What's
up?
Yeah, okay. Before we get started, though,
all right.
I gotta give a shout out. There's a camera girl here that had a birthday, and her name is Celia. Come here, girl. Yeah, I know you're working. Happy birthday to you. Everybody, come on.
Happy birthday.
She does. I see her on soda over there. I see. Yeah, she's drinking to that thing.
All right. Well, thank you for coming by.
Thank you, man. Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to get started really looking. You know, we always start from the very beginning. We have to know the roots, where we came from, what we
did. The roots.
Before all, before you came. So,
where I came from? Chicago. I grew up on the south side of Chicago. I was a class clown. I used to do like cartwheels to throw away something in the garbage. I always had jokes. And so my parents were like, we gotta get this kid into something, some type of hobby. So shout out to the parents that support the arts and support drama, because it definitely helped me out. They put me in a community theater program during the summer, and I just fell in love with the art of acting. And it was awesome, man. I remember the first play I did was called Kasimu and the Coconut Palm. And it was like Wizard of Oz meets The Wiz, you know what I mean? It was awesome. And it was awesome, man. I was a little snake, and I was like the narrator of the forest, and I would like do a little dance and talk and everything, like, here he comes, you know. So anyway, I fell in love with the art of acting, working, doing plays in my church as well, so that's how I got started, bro.
Yeah, so how does music then kind of fit into all
music? I love music as well, you know. I rap, I sing, you know what I mean? I'm singing in a choir. I sing in a choir in church. So music is a part of me, man. And then I always make sure that I do music with every film that I'm in. So, you know, with Mystery Man, we had a song on the Mystery Man soundtrack. Of course, Good Burger, you all know that one. You know, I'm a dude, he's a dude, she's a dude, cause we're all dudes. Come on, I'm a dude, he's a dude, she's a dude, cause we're all dudes. Hey! Yeah, I wrote that.
I wrote that.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I had fun. It was awesome, man. You know, so that was cool. Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah.
What? If thought, okay, this is going to be a very strange question. Bring music, bring
action.
Musicals? Is that a thing that's ever been something you've ever thought about?
Musical?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, they're doing a lot of the TV musicals and stuff like that.
And you're on a show right now.
Yeah, and I started out in theater. So, totally. You know, I've done a lot of musicals and stuff like that. So, I would totally go on Broadway and do that. That'd be a lot of fun. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, totally. So,
that's
Wayne Brady is a good friend of mine. Shout out to Wayne Brady. He's hilarious, man.
He's great.
Oh, yeah. We were in the Khalid's music video, Young Diamond Broke, together, so that was fun. You know that guy that says, send me your location, and that's Khalid.
We may have to have you do a concert here tonight if this keeps up.
Live at Comic-Con. What is it? It's the Great Philadelphia Comic-Con.
Yeah, you got it right, really. The Comic-Con is
here. I did get it right.
Yeah, exactly.
Comic-Con. Get your geek on!
So you're still friends? Yes, that is the slogan somewhere.
Yeah, man.
So you're staying friends though with your old castmates?
Yeah, of course. I just talked to Keenan, what was that, yesterday?
All right, you're that close.
Yeah, man, all the time, man. We're like family. That's my bro, you know what I mean? We have kids now, you know what I mean? I have a little 9-month-old, he has a 2-year-old.
Oh.
You know what I mean? And then I have my 2 older kids, and we hang out all the time. And my wife and his wife hang out. So, yeah, that's awesome.
It's got to be weird. You know, you're kind of like a child icon. People remember you growing up.
Yeah.
And now you're the one that has a kid that's gonna be.
It's awesome, man. We're still having fun with them, man. We like tell jokes with the kids and, and walk around and we're keeping ourselves young, you know, me and Keenan. So.
By the way, if anyone does have questions, please feel free to come up to this mic. We will have a segment where you can definitely ask anything.
You can ask whatever.
The open book is right there, so you can go ahead and start the line if you are at all interested.
Don't be scared.
I know he's ready to go. Yep.
Dude with his grapes in his nose.
He puts it in his mouth.
And what happens?
It comes out of his ear.
Wow.
Okay, so if you like Grape Nose Boy, let me hear your bloobity. Let me hear it. Yeah, make some noise for him. He killed it. Well, dude. Bloobity. He brought us on camera. Look at this.
I know, right? He's this guy's
impression.
You know?
I love it.
Yeah. What's up, man?
Good. This is actually a compliment, not a question, but you and Keenan were some of the funniest duos in the 90s.
Thank you, man.
You're like the Laurel and Hardy of the 90s.
Thank you, man. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, there's got to be talk of you guys doing some type of reunion. Transitioning to being behind the camera from here on out.
Well, no, it's for both. Both, you know, because I've been at the network for so long with my new show, Game Shakers, that's over there. You know, every Saturday night, that's a new show I'm doing over there. So, but yeah, man, I like being behind the camera and in front of the camera and producing new content. So it's a lot of content you're going to see through my production company. It's just a lot of fun, you know what I mean? So we're excited.
Yeah, and I noticed the jacket, by the way.
Yeah.
Jacket.
Okay, because.
Gotta show it off.
Because the 90s are all that. I don't know what that shoulder thing was. You know?
Yes, and that's in now, right?
Yeah. Oh, well, no, that was just.
Just have to work out that way?
Yeah. Well, the shirt, the jacket, it was my styles. I got styles in
there. Oh, you have all the clothing.
Yeah. We got t shirts, all kind of jackets and stuff, and so they hooked me up with this all that jacket.
Yeah, oh, that's very nice.
Yeah, you got good.
So you like sticking with the Nickelodeon?
Yeah, man. I like family entertainment, you know what I mean? I definitely do. You know, I have kids myself, so it's just awesome. You know what I mean?
So your plans are doing like a rated R movie.
Rated R. You know, I have done some things. I mean, if you look me up, don't look over the Netflix and type in Kill Mitchell, you'll see some stuff. Some other things. Doing films that you can bring everybody, you know what I mean? Like the whole entire family. Because of the fact that I have a new generation watching me, and then I have my parents watching as well, so it's like, you want to cater to the whole family, you know? Yeah.
To the fans all over the world, you've traveled to a lot of conventions, and talked to a lot of people.
Yeah.
Out of curiosity, you know, people come up to you with memorabilia and things that they want signed.
Yes.
The weirdest and strangest thing you've ever had this
time. Bro, this is some weird stuff, man. I had a screw and a tuna. The guy actually had tuna.
Okay.
He actually screwed a screw into the tuna, so the screw was hanging out. I was like, dude, that's awesome. I haven't seen that until I like grabbed it and I tipped it and all this tuna juice. Tuna juice went down my arm. I don't know if y'all ever had tuna juice on your arm, but you smelled like tuna for a while, you know. And then I had another guy that did the same thing, but he actually glued it around tuna. That was smart, so that's been a good one. Repairman cosplay, I see that.
Sure.
I've seen a lot of repairmen. That's been really fun, you know what I mean? So, you know, I'm thinking about going to a repairman, like, movie. We're thinking about but weird, though. Him fighting zombies or something like that. Like, I think, what y'all be into that? Yeah, man, what? Don't super dude in there too, huh? I don't know, we were talking about that. That would be kind of funny.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, cause I like fighting zombies.
So. Oh, sure. So you haven't done a film yet where you're fighting zombies? Why are you so behind the
times?
You gotta do the fight.
I gotta do the zombies? Okay. I work out a lot, so I gotta fight some zombies. the dumbest.
And of course, they come with you. Fans always will be coming up with you. All these weird, strange, unusual questions. Yeah, what was one that maybe you were asking about? Like, oh boy, I don't even know if I can answer.
Strange question?
It's just a weird
one. It's not strange, it's more of like where.
Where?
Yeah. You know, like, I'll be at the urinal, and then they're like, you know, who loves more soda? Can you do it right now? Can I finish this? My hands are a little occupied. At church, you know, they'll turn around, and the pastor's going and just start talking about Good Burger. You know what I mean?
Of course.
But, yeah, but I get perks, though. I get perks. Every, like, burger place I go to, me and my wife, we get free burgers, so.
That's not bad. That's
pretty good. Yeah, you drive up to McDonald's, they're all like freaking out in the drive. They're like, welcome to McDonald's, I'm at McDonald's, can I take your order? Give you all the nuggets you want. And so.
Is that the man? Do they demand that you do that?
Yes, they demand. Yeah, like I could go to a 5-star restaurant and if I order any type of drink other than orange soda, it's an issue. It's an issue. They're like, you're supposed to drink orange soda, man. What are you doing?
You were the person that people grew up with. You were the children saw you all over the place as someone that that made them laugh and made them smile.
Yeah.
What about you? What was the group of actors? Who were the people you were growing up with that kind of was like, this is who I am?
Definitely John Ritter. Yeah, I love John Ritter.
Why am I surprised by that answer?
I know you're surprised.
I'm a little surprised.
A lot of people are when they hear that, but I used to stay up at night after school, and Three's Company used to come on late at night. And so my mom was like, I need to be asleep, but I used to have the TV down really low, and they were showing, you know, Three's Company reruns. And, you know, a lot of people don't give him, like, the props for the physical comedy, but John Ritter's physical comedy was insane. And then I learned a lot from his physical comedy when I was at Three's Company late at night when I was supposed to.
Sure.
And then, later, like, I got to work with him on Clifford the Big Red Dog, which was cool. Like, he's Clifford the Big Red Dog, and I'm T-Bone, the little yellow dog on Clifford the Big Red Dog.
So you got to meet kind of like your
hero. Yeah, it was cool, man. And, like, John Ritter, Eddie Murphy.
Sure.
That's another one. I love watching Eddie Murphy and all the different characters he played, and that definitely helped. Richard Pryor. I was going to say Richard Pryor as well. Man, just a ton of them. You know, Dean Martin, Jerry Lewis. I can go on.
I don't think we might, but if you lost.
Yeah. You didn't know I would play T-Bone, huh? I saw y'all over there talking. Yeah. I freak people out with that. Yeah. Like, I see little kids, and then I'm like, be the best dog on your block. And then they freak out. It's a black man, but it's in. I get T-Bone. They get it. You didn't know that? Yeah. PBS.
Not the one that don't want to monopolize all the questions. If you do have any questions at all, remember this mic right up here is for you. So if you have any questions, if you have any comments, even if you have a comment,
hey,
we would love to hear from you.
What's up,
Jim?
What's up?
I was wondering, what's your favorite All That skin?
Ooh, that's a good one. I love Coach Creed. Like, Coach Creed was just so much fun. I could scream the kids all day, like, so, when he went out on a date, he went to a restaurant out on a date, and that was a funny episode for me, because usually you just saw Coach Creed where he was just at the school, but then this was him, like, on an actual blind date, and that was a lot of fun, man. I enjoyed that. And then, you know, of course, my favorite Good Burger sketch was the one where Keenan and I just, like, broke in the scene, and we just couldn't stop laughing. We kept laughing the entire time, and actually kept it. That was a fun one. That was really fun.
That, and I was wondering too, with the, all that musical performances, was there ever a musician that you were really starstruck by?
Oh, everybody. Oh, man. Yeah, but see, what was cool is that we got to hang out with them afterwards. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, the first one was TLC, which was like big, and then we got to sing our theme song. And then we got to kick it with them, like hang out with them, and now our friends were like everybody still to this day. You know? So that's a lot of fun. And then, I mean, we had amazing musical guests, you know, like Aaliyah, Usher, you know what I mean? Ryan
AC,
yeah, so it was awesome.
Thank you.
No problem.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hey. What up?
Hi.
What's up?
What made you want to pursue acting?
Ooh. That's good. Well, yeah, it was definitely, like what I said earlier a little bit, was my parents got me into this community theater because they didn't want me to go the wrong route. Like, I grew up, you know, on the south side of Chicago, so you had, like, yeah, gang violence, and then you also had kids going the wrong way. But that's the kids that were going the right way, but they were just like, I don't want them to have to, like, really choose the wrong thing. So they put me in community theater, man, so I enjoyed it, and it was a great hobby to have. And that's what got me started.
No problem.
Yeah. What's up?
Hi, Brittany. Who is someone dead or alive that you would love to have a great heart-to-heart conversation with?
Dead or alive? Heart-to-heart? Martin Luther King. That's what's up. I would love to sit down with him. That would be awesome. And just hear all the amazing stories. You know what I mean? And how he persevered with his faith and talk about his faith. That would be awesome. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Yeah.
Yeah. There's a good person who has a novel that I've been working on. This one that's been on the tour.
Steve Holland too. He was a great producer and writer. He still produces shows today. But yeah, I don't know. They wanted to do Nickelodeon started doing these book series, and they wanted to do book series. That was actually a really good book. It was a good read. But like I said, there's some surprises coming up as far as Nick Burton. Reshoot it and do like a different version, you know, because originally how the story was that it was a presentation. So the pilot episode was actually a presentation, and Nickelodeon said, this does well, and kids love it, and the range up through the roof, we'll pick it up as a show. And so, I mean, we all were just like putting it out there to see if it would actually work.
And then, yeah,
they were dancing and eating popcorn and all that stuff, but then they just, I don't know, they switched it up. Yeah, that would be cool. Yeah. Marvel.
Okay.
I have that same hat,
man. Oh, thank you.
Hi,
Kel. I'm a big fan of yours.
Thank you.
Go, Keenan, Kel, go all that. Go 90s.
Yeah!
I just want to say, Dirk Burton was a great show. I love that show so much.
Thank you.
Question, are you guys going to make a cartoon show out of it? Like, any cool for making a cartoon show based on that? I have to drive your bullshit and then be the character, but in the cartoon, like, you know.
An animation of it.
Yeah.
An animation of the bird.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
That would be cool.
Oh, man.
Yeah, man.
Oh,
that would be cool. I saw an animation of an artist, I'm trying to remember his name, but he did some artwork of SpongeBob. And add it together, which is pretty cool. You know, because SpongeBob ain't after me. You really think about it. Krabby Patties are good burgers. Think about it. Music with, you know, with Prince. And so, you know, just those type of films, I really did. Yeah, yeah.
Did you like your kids too, like the rock as well?
Yeah, my oldest daughter, she's have done a lot of plays and stuff like that. My son is more into sports, but he's funny, he's a comedian. But definitely, my daughter, oldest daughter wants to do forensic science. And then my youngest daughter, I don't know yet. She's only 9 months. So, but she's awesome. She's, you know, she's all over Instagram. She's like famous right now with her pictures. So I don't know.
Yeah, I'm a big fan. No, no. I watched it when I was a kid since I was like 11.
Thank you, bro. Thank you, man. Yeah. What up, man?
Not too much. I had kind of two-part question.
Two-part.
First off, what kind of drove you to go from being kind of a front of the camera, like a personality talent, to being kind of behind the camera producer and doing that kind of work?
Yeah.
And what would kind of advice would you offer to people who want to be behind the camera, doing the editing, videography, producing?
Okay. I got into behind the scenes because I saw, like, I started hearing a lot of stories from, like, Sylvester Stallone, and how he wrote his own projects, you know what I mean, like, with Rocky and all those. And then the Wayans brothers as well. I sat down with Ron Wayans, and he said, if they don't want to give you a project or you got an audition for it and they don't want to give it to you, you make your own. And he's like, that's what we did in our family. We, like, you know, we literally wrote our own stuff and, you know, put ourselves in it. And so I really like the idea of that. And then coming from there and writing with my friends and stuff like that anyway, I was like, you know what, I want to, like, put out material and things that I want to see and what I think the audience wants to see. And there's something magical in that as well, you know, just from the thought process to the paper to put it on film. And then the best advice is definitely, like, a lot of people, don't wait. You know what I mean? You know, God gives us all gifts, and, you know, you'll come up with an idea, man. Write it out, put it down, and get around your friends that are, you know, like-minded like you and want to get into the craft. Because, you know, there's friends that are around that you can do it with. And you grow a team, and you all can, like, win together, you know what I'm saying? So just put the project out there. So many free spaces like YouTube and, you know, Vimeo, like all these things that are, you know, you can put projects out now. Even better with your camera phone, your phone's like, just go for it.
This is really awesome.
What up, man?
So, bit of a odd question.
Okay.
How did you first hear about rumors that you had died? How did you respond to that?
I'm a good company with that because they did it to George Clooney. And a whole bunch of other, like, actors, so. But yeah, man, that's just weird. Somebody in a basement, you know, just trolled him and put that up, like, such guilt and stuff. And so, but it was, what was crazy about it was that a family member called me when that happened. And this was on MySpace. You know, pretty bad when MySpace was popping. And I picked up the phone. And they're like, yo, man! I'm like, what if I picked up the phone? Clearly. And then people started looking like, okay, well, what is Kale into? You know what I mean? All press is good press, man. So it was just like, it was all good. But I'm alive.
That's good to know. I wasn't quite sure. It's reassuring. And then, how often do people stop you to ask you how much you love your own
self? Every day.
Every single day.
Every single day.
Like 365 out of 365.
Dude. Yeah.
And finally,
it's all good, though. I don't get upset about it. It's all good.
Just
saw Lori Beth, the Living Wild Now thing. I see Josh all the time, he's in LA as well. Angelina goes to my church, so I see her every Sunday. So yeah, we all stay in contact, man.
I love Lori Beth, I'm working on it.
So
that's it.
Hey,
you're awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, man. Yeah. What you got there, man? What's that?
Squishable Strawberry.
Okay.
Is there anything that you want to do in Good Burger that they wouldn't let you, or like anything that you
That's a good
you
in the film or on the sketches? Was it something that we did? You know what? We were pretty fearless on there, man. Like, I think, like, a lot of the stuff that we thought wasn't going to get in there actually got in there. You know what I mean? So, we're pretty fearless about it. And they kind of let us just go, which was cool. You know what I mean? So, nah, no regrets, man. Like, we put it all out there. You know what I mean? Yeah. One thing that I would fix, though, is that my wig came off and I fell through the straw. I don't know if y'all noticed that. And they just kept that in. They kept it in. You know, wig fell off. His hair came off. But yeah, that was one thing I would change. So, yeah, man.
Thank you.
No doubt. Yeah. What's up, homie? The toaster. I'm sure it had to be Dan. It was either Dan and the writers. They had writers over there. It was Dan and Kevin Heath. They were all the writers over there. They have crazy ideas. So I'm sure it was them. You know what I mean? Because Toast Stories is just hilarious. You know what I mean? Yeah, I love that part, man. That was really my thing. There were crumbs everywhere. I like your shirt, by the way. Represent. Yeah.
Thank you.
What's up, man?
It's a hard time to do that.
Me too.
My question is, what's up with a character played by other characters, cast members and all that? Oh, I'd love to play that.
Oh. Okay, I'll give you some insight. I was actually supposed to do Bible information. Me to do vital information, me and Lori would crack up about that. Because she had a conversation with somebody over here. I don't know what happened. She ended up doing it. So she said she did something wild. I don't know, Lori, you gotta watch out for Lori. But I'm totally happy that she did it because it's so much better than Lori that doing vital information.
I just can't stop picturing you being the most beautiful I've ever been. It's just perfect for you to just do all the hat falls and cut up. Physical comedy, the jokes to the serious happiness and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Just like getting a little more, that would have been perfect for you too.
Yeah. That was the one. But it's awesome. I'm glad she got it.
The question is, has there ever been a funny or crazy or insane or just playing wonderful moment for a fan from your generation and this generation? I haven't met you or like instantly recognized you and had such a crazy comedy that's helping with you and other stuff like that?
Oh, all the time, man. I love, like, you know, talking to the fans and hanging out with them and, you know, shaking their hands. I mean, that's one reason why I started doing stand-up, like a tour of stand-up as well. Just because I wanted to like shake their hands and like, you know, see them eye to eye and get to talk to them. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for everything you've done for your life. I'm so grateful that you must be able to move you because the previous new power. It just means so much to see you.
Oh man, thank you. God bless you, bro. Good job. That's cool. Let me see that shirt, man. What the heck? Clay, Cloud City, that's cool.
How's it going, Kyle?
Good, man, good.
My question is, what brought about the Good Burger Jimmy Fallon skit?
So I was filming Game Changers, my new show I'm doing now, and we got the call that Jimmy, you know, Jimmy does the reunions. Like, he did the Saved by the Bell reunion, and he was like, I want to do this real cool with Good Burger. And so we're like, all right, let's get Keenan on here and give a call to the producers on my show, our friends with Jimmy's producers. And so hit him up, got Keenan on the phone. Keenan's like, let's do it, let's wrap it. And it was awesome, man. It was just an awesome moment. It was emotional, actually, because Keenan and I both hadn't been in those outfits in a long time. So it was funny, like, when I had the burger outfit on, he had Lester Oaks on, and we're walking through the hallways in NBC, and it was crazy. You know what I mean? Looking at each other like, it was fun, and our whole family was there, so it was cool. Yeah.
Well, awesome. Keep up the great work.
Thank you, brother. Thank you. Gia.
I had another question.
Okay.
On the Good Burger trailer, Jason Daniels there, coming in, was in the scene. He has a head shake and he's shaking, and then never made it to the movie.
make it in.
I wonder what happened to that scene.
There was a, was there another one that didn't make it in? That definitely didn't make it. Man, I think everything else made it in, but that was pretty much it. That was pretty much it. I mean, we had a lot of bloopers. Yeah, man.
Why is it in
the- I don't know. He got on the cutting room floor. I don't know. But I mean, maybe something with his contract. I don't know. Thank you.
You're sketching on all that.
Thank you, man.
I brought my girlfriend here with me tonight.
Where's your girlfriend? This girl. What's up, girl?
She never heard of it.
Well,
what's sketching?
Well, she heard of T-Bone.
Yeah. Show her to get her like.
What all that sketches should we show her?
Yeah.
What all that sketches should we show her?
Repairman.
Repairman, that's a good one. Repairman's a good one. First Ant, that was be a good one. Just show the whole show, man. just sit her down and show her the show, man. She'll dig it. It's not good stuff on YouTube over there. Yeah, right? Yeah. Yeah. Y'all should have a date night. Look, Netflix. Watch Good Bird. Good Bird is on Netflix. Yeah, get some popcorn. Get on the couch like this here. And put it on Netflix. Be nice. But how old are y'all there, man? I'm not living. Y'all grown, right? Okay, y'all look young. Little kids. And I want to get in trouble with your parents. They need to call me.
So you brought up stand up.
Yes.
Stand-up is
awesome, man. It's a whole different beast than like sketch. Because when I was starting, I've been doing stand-up for like 5 years now. So like, what's crazy about it is that when you come from sketch, you think like, hey, it's a show, so you get on stage and ready to perform.
Yeah.
But it's totally different. You know, like it's more like this, more conversational, more people to relate to you. You know,
what I mean? More interactive.
Yeah, interactive. I mean, I have physical on stage when I tell my stories. I'm a storyteller, you know what I mean? But it's more of like getting them engaged with you, like you're telling a funny story to your friends, you know, even though it's 100 and something people know this.
No, is it? Is that where you're willing to kind of step out of your more PG-friendly persona when you're doing comedy? Is that something where you feel a little more racy, I guess?
Or like, racy. No, I mean, well, but the material is definitely a devil. You know what I mean? I talk about more of their things, you know what I mean? Because I'm gonna die, so.
Sure.
yeah, man, it's fun. It's definitely trying to catch it. Yeah.
Specials.
Yes, yeah, we have been talking about that.
It's like something that's in the works.
Yeah, so you definitely have to check that out, man. Because I've been doing it for a while, so it's been fun.
So as we kind of wrap things up here, do you want to share any like what you're doing in the future, anything you want to let people know about that's coming up that you're really excited about, that you're really like gonna mystery man to
something? Whoa! They want mystery man too. Yeah. Y'all want mystery man too? Should we do that? You said invisible man. I'll be invisible man at that point.
Exactly.
That was a fun one. You should have asked about what we cut out of the mystery.
Oh,
that was a lot of stuff that was in that one. Oh, that naked scene, when I had to be naked, they told me it was going to be nobody in that room. Everybody was there.
Did you have like a little modesty thing?
Yeah, they gave me like a little thong that was the color of my skin, but I mean, it was basically still naked. So. But yeah, man, definitely catch me on my tour, my new show, Game Shakers, on Nickelodeon. Running right now, around third season. Also, too, I got my film coming out over there, too, called April 2nd. So, just a lot of great stuff that's coming out, so we're excited.
That is awesome.
Yeah, man.
Well, we're all excited. We're very happy that you're still getting work and doing everything because you're a lucky man.
Thank you, man, too.
You got the chance to say hello to us here.
No doubt. Thank y'all, Philly. I'm here all weekend. Where should we go to eat? Where should we go to eat at?
All right, thank you for listening.